Hello, everybody, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die Horde Night 738. At least I think it is. If everything's gone according to plan, it is anyway. Hello, water bubble. How are you doing, mate? Have we got everything we need? Keep forgetting I've got these few flaming arrows, actually. Sniper rifle. Oh, shit. Oh, I swear I brought... You are running out of disk space. Really? H drive. How did I get here? Didn't I bring any... Oh, no. You know... Oh, hang on. What the hell? Why have I got... Why have I got biofuel in here? That's really weird. It's Mr. Elegon. Oh, you know what I need, don't you? Repair kits. Urgently. Ah, there we go. Repair. Bitch bash bot. Oh, it used all three repair kits. Oh, bloody hell. It actually used all three. I'd love to know if these sticks of dynamite can actually be lobbed through the iron bars, but I don't think it's particularly advisable to test that today. You never know. We could give it a whirl, right? Lob a stick of dynamite down here. See what the area of effect is. What could possibly go wrong? Hello, Silver Wolf. How are you doing? Hello, Daft Woolly. Hello, Xeranthian. Hello, KFC. What are you up to then, Elegon? Are you able to get on a little bit today or what, mate? I can't remember where we were. I think it was layer 90, I think. I'm doing all right, thanks, Water Bubble. What about yourself, mate? We managed to get on before the 11 o'clock watershed, so I'm quite happy today. Done some fucking miles in the last 24 hours, I know that. 8:17, so... I mean, is there anything that we need to do? Whoa, what the hell happened over there? Oh shit, that's not good, is it? Oh, dicks. Well, that's not good at all. I thought we repaired. I swear we repaired. Do you think that's just been like a little... Oh no, we've not got any spikes. Throw spikes in there. Throw those in there. Throw that in there. How do we get out? Oh my Gideon, it's all gone a bit boo-boo. Where is it? Oh, there we go. Look. Let's see if we can get over there really quick and just stick her. Oh, flip it off. I'm going to need the axe to chop them up. Chop, chop, chop. Captain Vage, 3 months. How is that even possible, dude? Oh, thank you so much, Vage. I swear yesterday we got you as a new sub and today we've got you as 3 months. It's all incomprehensible. I have no idea what is going on at Twitch's end, mate. Thank you so much, Vage. Nice to see you again, mate. How's things? Hello, Token. How you doing, mate? Hello, Madeline. How you doing, mate? How's things with you? I've not seen you for a little while. I've not been on for a couple of days, mate. Well, I was on yesterday. I reckon stick a couple. I've got two left. I mean, how long does it take to make these damn things? I suppose it doesn't hurt to make 47. And sort of hope for the best, I suppose. Puppy power! Fucking hell. This is all going to go wrong, isn't it? 8:57. We've got a little bit of time. We've got a little bit of time. Do some repairs, eh? Oh, is that a light? I can hear someone. Have we got reinforcements coming over? Oh, you know what I've not done? I've not sorted Eggsy's account out. Shit, I said I'd do that. Sorry, Eggs. It's a man of y'all. Deja vu. How you doing, Mario? How's things, fella? Let me just put all this away, guys, and we'll be good to go. So one, two. Let's just throw everything in there apart from the spikes, which we'll keep there. We'll take a little bit more wood with us. Throw that back up there, down there. Throw that there. Shotgun. Right, there you go. I'm ready. I'm ready. I've got the hiccups now. I'm pretty much ready, I think. Let's go. How's things then, Vage? You all right, mate? where there's some strange shenanigans going on, isn't there? Have you been working, going to sleep early since I don't normally do the night shift? Yeah, I need to sort of like get some proper kip tonight, like as in relaxing deep sleep this evening. It's been all a bit of a flutter recently, mate. Hello, Blowar. How you doing, fella? Thank you for the host, Machete. And to the Raptor Squad, Lazarus, Eliania, and Roxas as well. And to Butternuts, Dark, and Sarks. Check my question above. What's it? Question above, Elagon? I think I'm going to have to clear out something on my H drive after this horde, because it's going to keep saying that, isn't it? Excuse me. Elagon. Oh, right. Oh, sorry. No, I'd already read it. Sorry, Elagon. Sorry, mate. I was sorry. I thought it was something else you were talking to. Yeah, we probably need to discuss it, mate, because I just don't know what the future holds right now. It would have to be UK-based, though, dude. To answer your original question, there's no point in it being in Germany or somewhere like that, mate. It's just going to have to be UK. For a variety of reasons, least of all fucking ping being, like, probably further down the list, to be honest, mate. I don't know, dude. I mean, yes, we definitely need to look into it. I know Arakan... The reason I've not responded too quickly, Elagon, is Arakan's also suggested it, but there's no way I can play on an Atlantic side server, so... It's definitely worth looking into, Elagon. And seeing how easy it is to set the game up and then see where we can go from there. I mean, potentially, the options it would offer us in terms of SDX, mate. It's just there's so much going on at the moment, Elagon. You know... We've got to sort out all these bits and cheer things for like the 15th of March. We've got the, you know, we're trying to get Anubis done. I mean, I know you already said all this in your DM as well, mate, but it's like there's never a spare fucking second to even breathe at the moment, dude. I wouldn't want to give anyone like false hope setting it up and, oh my god. I'm not sure whether that, I think that's me just being really bad with the Steam controller today, actually. The lag actually is not bad at all. In fact, I'd say there's very little latency. I think I just need to get in the swing. It's been a long time since I shot the old sniper rifle, to be fair. Already got one or two in. There's someone out there on the old Grumbodian Special Forces side. I'm not sure who it is, though. Oh my god, I'm all over the place. Look, conic shit. I got no excuse, because... We've actually got a really good connection at the minute. Try and settle down. I'm not getting anything, am I? How's things taking? You alright, fella? Hello, Genuine Cake. How are you, mate? Oh, no. Cheeky monkey! How you doing, Jasmine? How's things, mate? Did a little boogie with the zombies there, Jasmine. What the fuck's he doing up there? Fucking crazy bastard. But yes, to answer your question, Elagon, definitely. It's the only... I mean, you'll have noticed if you've been listening... Is that another one, though? Oh! Ah, oh, just missed him. Just missed him. Hey there, Dark Savior! Yeah, I've been mentioning more and more recently, Elagon, about how we can't continue like this. We're losing playtime. I can't update when I want to update. We're having performance issues. We're having... issues with people at that end not knowing how to update mods. The amount of time I spend on it, Elagon, is getting ridiculous now, dude. You'll know what it's like just from listening to Dread. He's had similar issues. You know, we just don't have time to micromanage this stuff like we're having to. So it's going to have to happen, Elagon. To answer your question, it's got to happen. If we're going to carry on playing on servers, we have no choice anymore. So I've just not had any time to even look into. I've got to stop playing like I'm playing. I don't think I'm hitting anything. Need to get back in the swing of it a little bit, I think. Do you want to take out the ones underneath us, mate, and stop worrying about the ones at distance? Who is it? Xeranthia. Or not, mate. One of us is going to have to look after that lot down there, aren't they? It's just my shots are so bad, Xeranthia. I'm probably the worst one to be doing this. Oh, my God, we've actually lost bars, dude. First time we've ever lost bars. I just nearly went over the edge, dude. I wish it'd stop saying that. Thing is, I haven't done anything else with my H drive, so I don't know why. I'll go and delete a game in a minute. All right, let's try and get back into some semblance of actually hitting zombies if we can. Hello, Trevor. How you doing, mate? What have you been up to then, Mario? There's no way, Beast, there's no way I'm playing on an Atlantic server. Not in a million years. To be honest, it depends. There's issues. To be fair, mate, if it's going to be me doing it, it's going to be a UK one. End of fucking story, mate. It's me that's going to be setting it up, footing the bill and all the rest of it. I want a good experience out of it, so... I mean, this one's based in London. The physical hardware for this server's based in London, and most people seem to have had a pretty good experience with it when it's up. All right, let's settle back into a bit of a rhythm, guys. We're all over the place. It's Xeranthian, it's come to help. Thanks for the help, Xeranthian. I appreciate it, mate. Come on, Mr. It's the policeman. There we go. Can't believe we've lost iron bars. To be fair, it's mainly because we've just not been repairing them, though. So I suppose it was only a matter of time, really, wasn't it? Oh, my God, really? It'd be nice, though, wouldn't it, Elegon? It would be nice, mate, to have a server that we can deal with as we see fit. I am, yes. It's told me a few times, bro. No idea why, because like I said, nothing's changed. I've literally turned the computer off yesterday and turned it back on today, so... I've not downloaded anything, or... I mean, even the save game stuff isn't even on that drive, so... Terrible shot. Oh my God, dude. These coppers are a nightmare, aren't they? I'm wondering if it's because Xeranthian and I are both quite high level, so it's kind of throwing the best of the best at us, you know what I mean? I'm guessing Xeranthian's level 200, the same as me. I've never seen so many bloody coppers. In fact, I'm going to run out of ammo way before daylight is, Xeranthian, to be honest, mate. See, this is where the game is fundamentally flawed. In this situation, what you do is you just stop killing zombies. All you do is you make sure they don't respawn any special zombies, like ferals or anything like that. And we just sit here and wait until morning and just let the perimeter take the brunt of it. It's only when we kill one that another... Oh, come on, dude. That was a fucking headshot, bro. Oh, my God. You getting a PlayStation 4 tonight, Dark? What, you getting the Pro or...? You're right, Beast, I did. Try the salad! It's weird, actually. We stocked up on, like, soups. He just shot backwards, that copper, then. I think the only thing that's passed my lips in terms of food in the last, like, 72 hours has been big soups and water. I've not had a coffee since Sunday evening. To put that in perspective, I can normally drink about 10 cups of coffee a day. I've actually not had a coffee since Sunday night. just water, just to try and keep myself hydrated, really. Oh, hitting the gore block. Oh, there's actually a copper there. I thought I could hit one. Down with you, foul beastie! Is he dead?
Yes.
I wonder, it'd be kind of cool if cops could crawl, actually. Big flopper-dopper belly buttons. Oh, you little sod. Literally, as I took the shot, he decides to do his little jink. We're going to get ferals in a minute, aren't we? I might switch back to bow. Have some bloody repairs after this one, haven't we? We'll have to get the forge running for the first time in weeks. Shut up about the low disk space. We know about the low disk space. You don't have to keep telling me about the low disk space. I don't think he's actually dead, is he? 32 shots left. Nowhere near enough to make it through the night. Not even close, bro. Have to switch out to the old arrows, methinks. Have you looked into prices at all, Elagon? I mean, obviously we need to ascertain what kind of hardware we need, don't we? New firmware update to PlayStation 4. What does it bring, Mario? What is it exactly? Anything, you know, worthy of note, or is it just, you know, tweaks and what do they always call it? Optimizations. I was reading a bit more about the old Switch. It's not looking too good for him, is it, at the minute? More and more problems popping up, you know, now it's nearly a week out in the wild. You know what, Ojin? You've refunded the game because I hated the physics of the mob zombies when the fun pinks decide to fix it. I have no idea what you mean by that. You refunded the game because of the physics of the mobs and the zombies. What do you mean, dude? I can think of 1,001 reasons to send this game back, but I'm not sure what you mean. The physics of the zombies. What physics? I'm not actually hitting him, am I? That's what really weird. But bloody hell, Zar, what's going on down here, mate? Look, he's gone to sleep. Look, you're alright, fella. I'd have been better on a downstairs duty, wouldn't I, to be honest? My aim with that sniper rifle was unforgivable, man. Can I start using it more, in between? You know, have a day out scavenging and using things. It's you get a bit rusty, don't you? That'd be him on fire, then. Does look kind of cool when they're on fire like that. I like it. Be alright. We'll be alright, geezer. Don't you sweat it. Oh, I love the fire arrows. They're so cool. They need to make them cheaper to make, because I don't think they actually do that much damage, do they? I think it is quite a slow dot, really. Friend has a slim, but I don't have any way to see the 4K stuff, so it doesn't. You're getting all told wrong again, Dart. I don't know why people keep talking about 4K in the PlayStation 4. You don't need a 4K TV, bro. The Slim and the Pro do not have the same performance on Horizon. Not even fucking close, mate. Not even fucking close, dude. I don't know why all this false information keeps getting out, Dark. The screenshot differences between the Pro and the Slim are fucking phenomenal, dude. It looks so much cleaner on the Pro. There's even additional textures and texture res definitions and everything on the Pro, mate. Far less fucking issues with the game, just general stability, blah, 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 blah. The Pro... I don't know why... I think it's just people that just talk shit, Dark. You're giving bad information to folks, mate. You know what I think? I think it's people with the Slims and the old PlayStation 4s who don't want to justify paying for the Pro. That you just spread bad information because they want to make it out like they're not missing out on anything. Trust me, there is a big difference between Horizon on Pro and Slim, mate. But good news you're getting one anyway. I mean, more importantly, good news that you're getting one, bro. I can't really read that at the minute, Bart, but rest assured, whatever is being interpreted there is inaccurate. If you're telling me there's no difference between the Slim version and the Pro version, they are grossly misinformed, and I find that very hard to believe if that's coming from Digital Foundry, mate, who've actually literally said exactly what I'm talking about here in terms of the upscaling, the better anti-aliasing, the additional ground textures, everything, mate. It's all there. It's all screenshotted. It's there for everyone to look at, mate. So I can't really read that and comment right now, mate. Eight cores, 16 gig of RAM, 500 gigabytes for about €25. What's that? A month, mate? That seems quite cheap, actually, Amazon. That seems cheaper than what we're paying. I mean, I'm probably paying $30 a month as it is for the two servers, dude. So that's ridiculous, mate. I thought that'd be quite a lot more than that, like about 40 quid or something like that, you know? Oh my God, there's so many down here. Yeah, they're both 30 frames per second. That's absolutely right. Yeah, they are both locked at 30 frames. I never said anything about frame rate, Doc. There's a lot more to a game than being locked at 30 frames per second, bro. See, it's one of the very first games where there's a noticeable difference between the two, so it's kind of been used as a bit of a flagship example. So trust me, whoever's telling you whatever, Dark, they are misinformed, mate. Getting buffering at Elegon. Everything looks okay on my end, mate. I'll have a proper look once the horde's over, dude. You at LBL? How you doing, fella? Ooh, these little sausages. I've never seen so many bloody... You see what I mean? These hordes are so much better than the hordes with starvation. Just because you actually get some freaking zombies, look. I'd like to see us do one of these without... You know, like on the pyramid. We might do that to finish this server off. We might build a nice simplistic pyramid and do what we did on the starvation server. I don't think we'd stand a fucking chance. You're right, it's a Paul. How you doing, fella? He's still not dead, I don't think. He did. Die, you bastards. That's really good value, Ellen. Really good value. Oh, LBL, thank you so much for the sub, bro. Thank you so much for the sub, dude. How you doing, fella? I've not seen you for a little while, LBL. How's things, man? Let's get some beautiful, gorgeous, chocolatey, fucking sub-loving chat for LBL, guys. Thanks, LBL. It's a bloody noise in these orbs as well, isn't it? I'll tell you what, they've done some damage down there, you know. They do a lot more damage on these sorts of vanilla hordes than they do on the starvation ones with the bloody boss zombies, don't they? I know what Zeranti mentioned, apparently they've started looking into food spoilage. Is the first little bit of info out there now? As in, you know what I'd really like to see is the gas tanks on the back of the zombies explode. You know, these guys, these ones here, you see the gas tank down there? Wouldn't it be wicked if you could shoot that and it'd explode? That would be so much fun. Just a little AoE effect, you know, just enough to hurt a couple of zombies or maybe blow some legs or arms off. That'd be so much fun. You've got to think that'd be really easy to implement as well, right? Oh my god, they are really deep in there, bro, you know? I think it's time to get the fuck down, innit? Holy shit on a stick. Really? Wow, dude. Thanks for the help there, Zeranthin. That could have got a bit airy on my own, mate. Yeah, oh, you're right, Unsullied. How are you doing, fella? Jasmine, you cheeky sausage with your music in the middle of the horde there. What were you thinking, woman? What were you thinking, la? Oh my god, lassie. Hey, I could have fallen off, look. We need iron bars desperately, don't we? I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll repair everything other than the bars. We'll go make some and bring them back over. Right, let me just sort out this low disk space. Let's have a quick look. I wonder why that suddenly started. Let's have a look. Whoa, what's happened there, dude? What have I installed? I haven't installed shit all. Oh, all right. Yeah, I have. Ah, right. Yeah, I have got quite a ridiculous number of. I've actually got Resident Evil on there. And I, admittedly, I have got 15 versions of 7 Days to Die. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. No, 12, sorry. Let's see what difference that makes. So that's Frida. I've got 65 gig just from deleting that. Okay. Let's come back to the game. There you go, guys. We should stop getting that message now. Right, okay. Don't think I really want any of this, to be honest, but we'll grab a little bit. So the update, thanks, Unsullied. So the update is life of feed spawnage, and they mentioned that you can turn it off by removing some attributes from the XML. Right, oh, okay. So they're sort of making it, if you like, customizable. Hello, Blind, how you doing, fella? Jaffa cakes are shit, mate. You want to get yourself some proper hobnobs, dude. We've spoken about this. Jaffa cakes are not nothing special, bro. Jaffa cakes are evil. They're not a cake and they're not a fucking biscuit. Despite the lore case, not having none of it. They're evil little rascals, those Jaffa cakes. I did, Jasmine. It's a bit airy up there, mate. I tell you, jiggling about, doing the old shuffle. Wow, they did a right number on us, didn't they? I wonder how many spikes I've got inside. See, to be honest, if I'm going to play Starvation, I'm going to play it with everything turned on. At no point will I be turning things off. I'd like to play it how they wanted us to play it. So we can test it, really. But that's at least a week away yet, so. Oh, you little cheeker. Oh, come on, that was a fucking headshot, bro. Come on, sir. Come on, sir. I need some wood as well, you know. It's not just a case of repairs. We need wood, we need concrete, we need rebar. Definitely better hordes in vanilla than on Starvation. I don't care how you look at it. Definitely better. Just more fun. Only more fun because there's just more happening. Right, I've got a couple of iron bars. Anything in there, I'm going to take back to camp. So, might as well keep some nails and bits and bobs in here. We have got some forged iron. I've got some. Oh, shit. No, that's not going to work, is it? All right, so let's just throw up. Don't seem to have my nail gun. I'm guessing I left it somewhere. Oh, shit. We've not got any concrete. Oh, fucking hell. Oh, shit. Houston, we have a problem. Shit. No concrete, lads. No concrete. I don't know why I've got that. I'm going to get rid of some shit that I've got no intention whatsoever of using anytime soon. Let's take the rebar. Can't see myself using that. Got some of this. Let's put the expensive crap down here, yeah? I mean, what's the point in having that then? Ammunition. Bedroll, bit of spare. Food. Get rid of it. Bucket of water. Why have we got a bucket of water over here? Really? What's that? Grumbul, well, anything less than 30 frames per second can be shocking to play. Graphically, I'm not fussed as long as it plays nice and keeps it engaged. Yeah, I mean, I'm not disputing that, though. I mean, I'm not here to argue the toss, mate. I'm just telling you there is a difference between the PlayStation 4 Pro version and the Slim version, and anyone who claims there isn't is literally grossly misinformed, mate. As you quite rightly say, I mean, the most important thing is having a locked, stable frame rate. Yeah. There's a lot of lies goes on around the PlayStation 4. A lot of it from the Xbox fanboys who don't want to admit it is significantly better than their bit of kit. But also, like I said, so that kind of buyer's remorse issue that you have with folks who don't want to admit they've not got the best PlayStation 4 out there. This is just the way the world works, isn't it, mate? You alright, Stripe? How you doing, fella? Well, the way I looked at it, because obviously I had to rebuy Dark, the way I looked at it, mate, for a brand new one was going to cost me $200 to $250. The Pro was going to cost me $350, so it was a no-brainer for me, mate. Absolute no-brainer. If I was buying brand new, I definitely wouldn't have bought the Slim. I don't like the Slim. I prefer the original ones anyway. The only reason I'd get the Slim over anything else is for the better Wi-Fi card in it, and I mean, that is a must-have. But for an extra £100 for what I get, because it's not going to be one game. I mean, this year alone, we're going to be seeing... I mean, you imagine what The Last of Us is going to look like on the PlayStation 4 Pro. The Last of Us 2. I mean, that is going to be something fucking spectacular. I mean, we've already seen what Guerrilla Games can pull out of the bag with Horizon Zero Dawn. Imagine what Uncharted 2 is going to look like. Sorry, Uncharted 2. The Last of Us 2. Have a quick look. Right, how are we doing here then? We've got a lot of repairs. I don't think we've ever seen a fuck it so badly beaten, actually. In fact, I don't think we ever have had a fuck it beaten quite so badly. That's pretty... I think the server settings were a little bit more crazy on this one, in fairness to Starvation, so it's probably not a fair comparison, in all honesty. Will there be an evening stream? I don't know yet. Who? It depends if we get a phone call later. I have got to go back up to Birmingham later this evening, but I might go a little bit later than I did yesterday. So I just don't know yet who are. I'm sorry, mate. I wish I could be more specific, but with everything that's going on at the moment, I just can't, dude. You're right, Benjamin. How's things, fella? Get repaired what we can get repaired, and then we'll go back around. I think I'm gonna nip back to home base and grab some concrete. Yeah, because this is gonna take forever with this thing, isn't it? Jesus Christ. How many I've only got 43 spikes as well. Bloody hell, fucking fuck. I tell you what we could have done, actually. We could have just left it and just see how badly damaged the full fuck it gets with no repairs. See how many hordes she can survive. See, but what level is Czar? Is he 200? Yeah, we're both level 200. Look, and I bet neither of us have died in like months. Yeah, Yeah, so I do feel bad about it though, Huar. Honestly, mate, I really wish we could get back to a bit more of a guaranteed schedule, but it's a tough one, mate. It's just a tough one at the moment. I did wonder what you were doing at one point, Zeranthian. To be honest, I thought it was eggs, but eggs can't get on at the moment, can he? If you see eggs in chat, get him to shout out. I'll get him sorted. Jeez, man, we are definitely going to need more concrete. It's just the one game. Yeah, if you're only getting one game. I mean, and the thing is, Dart, you've got the game then anyway, haven't you? So when you do upgrade, you can always go back and have a look at it, you know what I mean? Knocked out. Right, okay, let's not sure what to do here. Get these placed up. I suppose we can say that's one side completely repaired, isn't it? Jeez. I really want to get back to the Anubis one, so I don't actually want to be spending too much. I'm almost thinking, fuck it, and leave it as is, and then come back with the stuff that we need. You know, like, so we're a little bit better equipped. But I don't think I've even got enough concrete to actually do... Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh yeah, we probably have. We can probably just about. I can't remember the last time we had a breach on the Commander Yan walkway. In fact, I don't think that's ever happened before. I suppose if you're not constantly repairing, I mean, this base probably hasn't been repaired since. God, what you were like day 200s maybe. Because we've been using the cobblestone fuck it a lot, haven't we? Where's the best place to get wheat? In the sort of savannery kind of areas, mate. Not the desert. These sort of is this the savannah? I can never tell the difference from the overhead map. That looks more like desert to me. The savannah's kind of like a more... Hang on a minute. What? Why is my map not all rivet? Oh, I don't know. Savannah, basically. Whoa, 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 sir. I don't think so, maybe. You've been sick and at the end of the... Yeah, oh, you what? You've been poorly, have you, Benjamin? I'm sorry to hear that, mate. Yeah, I think it would just be more cost effective to go and get some wood, stick it in a workbench, get it to make me some spikes, bring over a bit of concrete and a nail gun, and we'll have this done in like a matter of minutes, won't we? At the moment, I'm going to be hitting and bobbing all the time, so we'll get back to Anubis, I think. It's 4-6-3, so I suppose if we come back on, what, 4-6-8? And like have a good day over here. We can maybe do a bit of inventory management as well. General fucking map. God, Mike, this fucking headset's all crackling again today. Oh, dude, really? That'll do us. I'm gonna leave it there, Zeranthium, unless you suddenly decide to take it upon yourself to repair the old fucking thing, mate. I just don't think I've got enough concrete to finish it off. Yeah, I think this is like the desert here in Sully. Do you want something that looks a little bit more like this, I think? This kind of sort of browny poop colour. Well, I hope your poop isn't that colour. The barbed wire slows them down really well. The A-frames and the horizontal normal barbed wire. It's actually a really good tactic if you want to go for an active engagement with a horde. I think personally, if I was to rebuild a fuck it in vanilla, and I wanted to keep up with the target practice element of things, which is good fun, I'd probably lose the spikes and just put in three layers of A-frames. It'd certainly be interesting to see just how much that enables us just to keep pew-pewing. Oh, nowhere near, Doc. Nowhere near, mate. No, no, no. I've only played it for something like, I think 8 hours, but I think we've only had 2 sessions with it, dude. Yeah, about four-hour sessions. Eight, maybe a little bit more, dude. So no, I've hardly even touched it, mate. Hardly even touched it. It's going to be really hard going back for me, Dark. Really hard, because it's such an intuitive kind of combat system. It's got a real flow to it, and it's really easy to forget that almost like the timing of everything. So when I go back, I'm going to have a good hour just hunting animals and fucking about. I had a couple of fights with slightly more advanced creatures in the last session, and it was a real eye-opener as to how much you can do in a fight. I mean, straight away, I completely forgot to scan them. I won't drop any spoilers, mate. So I didn't know about, you know, the weak spots, which you know from the very first 10 seconds of the game, mate, so it's not a spoiler. It was quite an eye-opener as to how much of an arsenal Aloy has actually got from day one. And I hadn't really taken advantage of it, to be honest. This survivor or Anubis? Starvation, you mean? This is Anubis, mate. Good old Anubis. I'm going to treat myself to a new bike today as well, wasn't I? As soon as this one's all crapped out. Head home. Let's go back to Anubis, level 90. Whoop, whoop. Definitely Dark. I compared it very much to an experience I had with God of War Dark, where I had played God of War 3. I'd actually played the demo like endless times before it released. And I really do mean I think the demo took about 15 minutes to complete, if that. And I probably put about 15 fucking hours into it, mate. It was ridiculous. So when the game released, I did actually get, you know, without touting my own fucking trumpet too much, mate, I did actually get pretty damn good at God of War 3. And I took a break from it because I'd finished it and went back. It was either a year or 2 years later. It was a hell of a chunk of time, mate. You know, I'd finished the game, went on to other things, and then just decided to boot back up God of War 3. I'd had such good fun with it. I thought, yeah, let's go back and have a play. I couldn't even do the first fucking boss, mate. I literally got my ass handed to me playing at that difficulty setting, dude. There was just no freaking way I was going to beat it. And I didn't carry on with it as a result of that. The challenge wasn't there for me, having already done it, you know what I mean? So, but yeah, definitely, there's an extreme fluidity to the combat. And it's one of those games where you can just get by. I don't think the game's particularly difficult. You can definitely just get by being really bad. You're going to struggle with some of the bigger bosses or mobs as such, I would have thought. I mean, I've only seen like one or two that are slightly out of the scope of the norm. But on the flip side of it, you can also become a player, I should imagine, who could become extremely adept at taking down specific enemies in a particular style extremely efficiently. And that's what I kind of like about those games, you know. There's not a high barrier of entry. I mean, God of War, let's be honest, you could probably spam click your way through it in the end. But playing God of War 3 well was a bit like performing a dance, really. It felt right, it felt good. You felt like, you know, you've done a bloody good job when the combo's all tied together effectively. God of War was horrible to take a break from. I played the one the hardest time. Yeah, that's right. And I remember going back to school. Yeah, it was God of War 3 for me, mate. I think nothing would work, mate. I mean, at those difficulty settings, you definitely can't just button mash your way through it. It's never going to happen. But I went back under the mistaken sort of impression that I would probably be able to still hold my own and just have to play it a bit to reaccustom, you know, myself with all the controls and the combos. No fucking chance, mate. Fucking no chance, dude. I think after about the 40th death, the DualShock 3 got put away, and The disc was removed from the PlayStation 3, so yes, thank you very much. I won't be playing that anymore. See, Horizon's a bit different, I think. I mean, we're playing one above normal, I think. We might even whack it up. I think it's one of those games where you can change the difficulty midway through, so... everywhere in London was sold out of pros. Yeah, I think they had new stock in. Well, it's got to have been about 2 weeks ago. I know Xeranthi managed to grab his, didn't he?
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. But when I see you hanging about with anyone, it's not unusual to see me cry.
I've done loads. What are you on about, Blind? I've done loads of defences of fuck it on my own. Easy peasy. In fact, I think it's easier on your own. I wouldn't be too happy if there were like level 200s underneath. I don't think she'd survive too well there, Blind. You're talking about trying to get like the max sized horde we can. We should just set a load of forges up as well, Blind. Have everyone on the server log in, fire up a load of forges, everyone else stays down, and just one of us stay at the top just to film how much damage they do. How you doing, Mojo? You're right, fella. You saw up to the point of me getting the mount. That's where I got to, Doc. That's as much as we've played, mate. I haven't played anything since then, dude. Or that session, let's put it that way. It is, Doc. It is. Send me another reminder, dude, and we'll have a bish bash bosh with that. What was that? I just saw someone say something. I missed it. Not sure. Grux Wreck, what's that? Chat, what does more damage, flaming arrows versus steel crossbow bolts? Steel crossbow bolts, mate. Flaming arrows actually don't do that much damage, dude. They're awesome and they look absolutely wicked, but damage-wise, I don't think they're actually that good at all. They might do a hell of a lot of damage, but the thing is, if it does, I've never been able to witness it because you just shoot them with another arrow. I'd like to see flaming arrows really have a use, to be honest. Quite often used to talk about like certain zombie types maybe having to have the fire dot in order to do other damage. And I think that's the kind of stuff I'd like. You know, we were always talking about these juggernaut zombies and things. I think we overthought it, to be honest. I honestly think they should go back to some pretty basic stuff. Like what I said earlier about... Oh god, meat stew stacking 50s now, look. Like the gas tank on the back of the hazmat dude. That would be brilliant. You know, being able to do that, having the zombie cops have a different weak point to, which I think has been spoken about somewhere, to the normal zombies. It's not just about having different zombie types, it's about making them unique, isn't it? Enabling them to do or not do something. We could even have zombies that might carry like a bit of dynamite, like the minor zombies, like 1 in 10 minor zombies will actually have a stick of dynamite and you'll be able to see it burning. And if he gets close to you, say within 5 blocks or 10 blocks, it'll detonate it. I don't think it needs to be as elaborate as what Starvation's doing, even though I really like the Starvation stuff. Oh, Tony, how you doing, fella? I think there's lots of scope to make things fun and interesting without having to go down the route of whole new character models and stuff, but... Yeah, that's it. Like maybe bring in some sort of, I mean, I don't know. Some sort of zombie type. I mean, let's have some different types of arrows. They've got flaming arrows. What about some sort of electric arrows? I know it might be bordering on the, that's not quite in the keeping of a grounded game. But I'm going to be honest, feral zombies are stupid. What the fuck is the feral zombie supposed to be? You know, he looks like an alien, not a fucking zombie. So yes, yeah, so, you know, certain zombies are weak to certain, or even if not weak, maybe that's a better way of doing it than making it so they have to have a fire dot. To make certain zombies, you can pump like say a normal zombie takes 2 headshots during a horde. So say you're playing on that sort of difficulty setting. I mean, I wouldn't like that, but in fact, let's just narrow it down. Let's say a zombie takes 1 arrow to the head, yeah? So a good quality bow or a good quality crossbow, a steel arrow to the head kills it. Maybe make it so that there's a particular zombie type that would take 6 arrows to the head in order to kill it, but would only take, say, 1 flaming arrow to the head, and the dot on that would be enough to take it down in, say, 3 seconds or something like that, you know? I'd like to see them play about with that a little bit. The hazmat guys with the big barrel, you know, like the gas tank on the back, like if you hit that with a flaming arrow, I'd like to see it explode. Some people got the real problems. Some people like hey, Kerry. Some people think oh, no, what happened? Is that my headset? I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put the blame on me. The song stopped halfway through there. I think it's my headset. It's completely fucked. I think it's literally now had it. So if you can tell me that song did not stop halfway through, at least I know it's my end. How you doing, Socks? How's things, fella? You alright, mate? Yeah, you know, I think there's lots of things they could add without having to go crazy. I mean, you've got to think there's hit detection and stuff. Is already in place, you know, maybe add like another hitbox to certain zombies. You are Iceberg TV, how you doing, fella? Getting stuck on the breeze blocks. How you doing, Asimaldo? Nice things, man. I love that tune, dude. I really like that tune. So two of the top tunes played back to back there. We got Sarx's and Asimaldo's. Nice one, guys. Sorry, what was that? Professor Pie, hello! How you doing, Professor Pie? Might I recommend the VModder Crossfade LP2? What? Is that the one that you got, dude? Is that like super high quality headset you got? Wait, are you talking about another one? The problem with that one, it's not wireless though, is it, dude? But for my gaming, as opposed to my listening to music or films, I always go wireless. I also have to have an optic. An optical out to the headset or to the mixer. It's essential for my setup, so I don't know if it offers me all that, dude. It might just be a bit of interference. I have got like 3 mobile phones in here at the minute. So I'm kind of hoping that it'll get better once we're back down to like my normal 2. You just woke up drinking Monster. Oh, dude, you should not be drinking Monster in the morning. I'm rather partial to a Monster myself, mate. However, I think, you know what's really weird? With everything that's going on, right? All I've actually eaten in the last 3 days is basically Heinz Big Soups and water. I've not had any coffee or juice or anything like that. And you know what? It's kind of quite weird. It's, It's not like I feel any better. But, you know, I think sometimes just going for the simple stuff. The simple brothy brews. Hello. Stews in the water. It doesn't do you any bad. You know, it certainly don't do you any harm, does it? Gribal Beer, how you doing, mate? Thank you very much for the follow, fella. What sort of Monster, Iceberg? I'm rather partial to the one in the white can. I don't know what it is.
Grum, you're either too hot or too cold.
Oh, you're right.
Perhaps a beverage or a nice wardrobe change will help.
Thank you very much. Doing good here. Just woke up after the first night shift. 4 hours of sleep for the win. Oh, God. I'd kill for 4 hours right now, mate. Sun's coming up where you are. Making something sweet and letting you rest up, Professor Pi. Rest up, mate. They are wide, but they also have a wireless version. Ah, right, okay. Speak of the devil. and the devil shall arrive. Now, Daikoi, you can answer me a question while you're here, if you would be so kind, mate. You know your Sennheisers that you've got, yeah? Does it come with, like, a little mix amp or anything like that, dude? Or not? Or is it, like, basically either wired or... Well, no, you're presumably, like, a USB dongle, is it, with yours, Daikoi? Yes, I think it is Elegon. I don't think there's any major issues with it, bro. I'm pretty sure I did do the check. In fact, I think I started backfilling it Elegon, in which case it's definitely been checked. So, yeah. Yeah, it's not because I'm doing anything in particular, though. I mean, normally I eat like an absolute monstrous... Oh, actually, I tell a lie, mate. I've been eating... I knew there was something else because I eat shitloads of protein, mate. Sardines. John West sardines in tomato sauce. I've been munching on those whenever I can as well, so... Your diet took a shit and you were starting to feel bloated all the time. Oh dear, that doesn't sound very pleasant, mate. What, like, just like a big, big floppy tummy full of water? That sounds horrible, mate. Your youngest is sending you off for chopping the tree down. Oh no! I'm so sorry. I'll do three more. Count with me. One little tree sitting on the ground. Ho ho. No, it's not. Two little trees sitting in the ground. Ho ho. No, it's not. And sing along, Kerry. Oh, it's just gone. My headset's just completely gone. Can you hear sound? Oh, it's completely died. I've got no sound at all. Oh, fucking bollocks. Oh, fuck. That worked. That seems to have worked. Let's hope it stays all right. Fucking hell. So it's dead weird not having sound. It's like, hang on a minute, that's a bit spooky. I don't like that at all. So you've got a USB mixer, charger, transmitter, and it's SteelSeries. Oh, sorry. Yeah, sorry. I did know that, mate. We spoke about it enough times, didn't we? And you've recently got the optical cables for it. I definitely think that might be the one for me, to be honest, Eichel. I like the thought of having the double battery pack from day one. And it wasn't that ludicrously expensive either, was it, dude? Yeah, hopefully your game sound didn't go, but... Wait, there's no reason why your game sound would go. Three little trees sitting on the ridge, ho ho, ho ho. Two little trees standing on the ridge, ho ho. Should we plant some trees for Kerry's little one? Come on, let's go and show, you know, let's teach the kids something useful today. Here you go, look, we're going to plant some seedlings, little Kerry person. Look, we'll be good. Look. Planting little trees, look. That'll grow into a big tree, like this one up here. And then Grum will come and lop it down, but we'll hopefully do it when you're fast asleep, mate. Oh, this crackling in my headset's driving me fucking potty. I have to put my little earbud things in. I don't like earbuds. They're uncomfortable for me. I've never, ever, ever worn earbuds that... Maybe I just got the wrong sort. I mean, you've got to assume there's like all sorts of different shapes and sizes, right? I did have some with something I bought that came in like this little pack with... Oh, I'll tell you what it was. It was something Sony related. I wonder if it was the first Sony PlayStation 4. I can't remember. That had like different plastic nubbery bits. I don't know, that you could sort of attach like fat ones and thin ones to better accommodate your ear size. But I still never found anything that sort of felt right. There you go. Look, trees planted. Conservationist look. Alfie Ray. Hello, Alfie Ray. It'll be 2 on the 2nd of May. Oh no, so nearly two, will be two in May. Sorry, I thought you said will be two on the 2nd of May. You alright, Alfie? How you doing, Alfie? We might sing about bottles of beer, alright, Kerry? Bottles of beer on the wall. How you doing, Demon Tex? How you doing, fella? It used to be called the Steel Wires Wireless H, but they changed it shortly after the Siberia 800. It cost two. Whoa! Fucking Christ! Hang on a minute. I didn't know it was that much. Fucking hell. Fuck that. I thought it was $149.99, Daikoi. Holy shit. Still, I was feeling super tense all the time, and my acid reflux kept kicking up, and I was feeling really nauseous too. Oh shit. When you say, what's purging mean then? When you say purging, what do you mean? Is that what they'd call in the UK, like a detoxifying or something like that? You know what I mean? Right, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to go and make, say, 100 spikes up in this here. And then they'll be ready to take back to the fort. So if we say, take all of this back to the build. How are we doing for cobble-wee-wee frames, Elagon? Let's check ammo as well, because in the next horde... Hang on, we've got 600 gunpowder. Still got enough for the next horde. And in fact, I'll tell you what I'll do while I'm here. Take some of those as well. Food and water's not too bad. Should we just go then? Deadpool trailer is out. Deadpool 2. It only seems like fucking yesterday Deadpool the first one was out. Thought you might have meant the Steel series, Daikoi. What? I wasn't sure because you were talking about the name change. So I was like, Steel Wires. Steel series, Steel Wire, Wireless H. Doesn't quite sort of sound right, does it? Anyway, Daikoi, all that bollocks aside, mate. How is Ghost Recon, dude? How is it? Anything found out in the last 24 hours since we last spoke that has made you realize it's even better than you thought? You all right, Ice Tiger? How you doing? Ah, that's just a little something we knocked up, fella. You like to have 7.1 sound? There's a lot of bollocks around 7.1, isn't there, Sarks? There's like true 7.1, and then there's the very fake 7.1 that everyone... true 7.1 is fucking expensive for a headset, dude. Right, there she is, mate. There she is. Looking good. She's looking very, very, very good. Let's go. Oh, nice one, Taranthi. I remember you mentioning the splints. Thanks for that, dude. You're still living it. Haven't gotten to the third zone and loving that the climate is different for each zone. So, I know it's going to be a bit spoilery in a way, Daikoi. Can you just tell us what the zones are? So, first zone is presumably where we started with the beta, right? So, that's kind of like you sort of more dense, foresty, sort of open fields and all that kind of stuff. What's the second stage? I hope no one minds me asking. Just ignore what Daikoi was about to say if you don't want to spoil. Let's have a look. How much are these? Asus.com. Asus.com? Is that Asus as in that make computer parts socks? I didn't know they even did headsets, mate. Let's have a look. Oh, the Strix. Oh, the Strix 7.1s. Oh, these are supposed to be fucking amazing, mate. How much are they, dude? I've got no idea how much they are. They look a bit... I don't know, they... I just don't like them aesthetically, mate. I've never liked that kind of... I don't know. It's too gamey for me, Sarks. It looks like something that's trying too hard to look like a gaming headset. You know what I mean? I'm not knocking the quality or anything. Just my gut impression is that it's trying too hard. Does it really need these, very angular, sort of octagonal-y kind of... sharp edges and... This has actually got 10 discrete drivers, you see. So, I mean, you're actually presumably getting true 7.1 on that, aren't you? As opposed to the nonsense nearly every other gaming headset tries to fob you off with. Yeah, that... Supposed to be. I mean, I've never used them. Sark's never, ever used them, but I've heard very good things about Strix headsets. I don't know why they went for that design decision. It's almost like they've got a really nice headset that they've made look cheap and tacky. Yeah, well, that's your cool, Sark, whereas I do care about things like that, you see. I don't want to be sitting there with a headset on that looks like I'm some sort of fucking Call of Duty fanboy, you know what I mean? It matters to me, mate. It matters. Style is everything when it comes to your PC. You gotta have some neon lights to your computer as well so it goes faster and things like that, you know? Download your RAM. How much were they? Did you say how much they were, Sark? How much did you pay for them, dude? A lot of people go for the Astros these days, don't they? But again, to be honest, I don't know what the Astro stuff's like these days. I really don't. Oh my god, if someone keeps organizing this into the neatest fucking box ever. Very impressive. Oh, hang on. I'll tell you what. Let me go and take this cobblestone back to the... You'd be alright there for a minute, wouldn't you, mate? Go and take this cobblestone back to the Sphinx. It's not about vanity, Sarks. It's about not looking like a dickhead. It's literally about not looking like a knob. And those Strix make you look like a knob, dude. Simple as. It's nothing to do with vanity. I just want them to work and not look like something a five-year-old knocked up, mate. They look like something out of fucking Call of Duty tournament. I can imagine all the kids. Yo, what's up, man? Check out my Strix, bro! If you don't care, that's not a problem, mate. But I would care. I couldn't in all heart ever wear a headset that looked like that if anyone came around, you know. I'd have to hide them. One, two, three, four, five, six. Put those back. One, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, shit. We've not got enough blood. Tell you what, let's put three back then. Let's take that. Put that one there. One, two, three, four, five, six. Hang on a sec. Hang on. One. Go on, pick a minute. Do you need any wood over there, Alagon, or not? Hey, if you're happy looking like a knobber, mate, I'm not going, you know, I'm not here to judge you, mate. That's your call, bro. So you literally don't care what you look like. When you leave the house, Arch, you don't give a fuck what you look like. I mean, if that's your definition of vanity, then I think you and I have quite opposing opinions on that. Yeah, I think we've got another 3,000 cooking up, and I'm bringing another 6,000 over. So I think Xeranthine's been doing a few runs for us. We definitely need to get all these iron bars sorted, though. We are getting really, really quite susceptible to spawns from Sphinx hitting Anubis, which frankly worries me a little bit. So I'll bring this up to you. I might go and bubble up some iron bars, mate. They're 164. What, the Strix are only 165 quid. That is pretty cheap. But then again, I don't know what they've sold for in the past, though, so. So you just went to the two school zone to the east of the starter zone. More lush mountains than the first zone. The third zone is like a huge lake. Oh, yeah, because I thought we might have spotted this Dykel. You know when I went into the second zone and I saw what looked like a dam? And I went flying off in the chopper, but unfortunately the game sort of started putting me out of bounds and I had to return. But yeah, it looked like a lake with some sort of massive, and I do mean massive, dam built across it. I was quite impressed with that. Right. I'm going to leave you with that, Elagon. You've got plenty of frames. You've got plenty of rebar. Let's bring this down here. I am going to go and get... I'll tell you what, let's leave that in there then. I'm going to take the water back. You've got a little bit of food. You want some food, don't you? Oh shit, iron bars. Xeranthine's brought them over, look. Oh, you little star, mate. I don't think that all needs to be in there, really, does it? But then again, what am I going to do with it if I take it? So let's leave it. Let's go and get the bars done. Do a bit of defensive work. Oh, no. Shit. I thought my sound had gone then because I didn't hear myself land. You never hear yourself land, do you? I suddenly thought, oh, not again. you streamed Minecraft Story Mode last night. I had a total of 7... Oh, nice one, Kerry. Chadwy was talking, and one of the person talked for a while. Hey, did you get on with Minecraft Story Mode? Is that from the start, is it? From the very beginning? I've heard pretty good things about Minecraft Story Mode myself, but at the same time, I think when I mentioned it in chat, everyone was like, oh, it's fucking terrible. Oh, I actually, everyone that I know, if you like, in the real world, as in that I've met and spoken to sort of around Christmas that had played it last year, they actually really recommended it. But then again, they are massive, massive Minecraft buffs, so I suppose that doesn't surprise me. Go and get some concrete and... Oh shit, did I bring the nail gun? I did. Uh, 90, I do believe, Elegon, but double check it. You'll be able to tell from the nipple. I'm pretty sure it was 90. We've still got, I mean, we're coming up into the head area now, James, look. So no, I mean, she's nowhere near finished, but she's a damn sight better off than she was. Done quite a lot of work last week and this week, so. I mean, I think we probably did a good 10 plus 15 layers yesterday, maybe. I'm gonna take a little bit of concrete, a little bit of rebar. Go and patch this perimeter up so we know we're safe for another couple of days or so. If I take 1, 2, 3, and 1, some more cobble wee wee. Well, I'm glad you had a good night, Kerry. That sounds cool, mate. That does sound cool. So they're 200 and they're 100, they cost you 180. So, I mean, you know, it's not a massive difference, is it? Tritons have HDMI pass-through. They're annoying to wear. In what way? What do you mean by annoying to wear then, Dark? You're just not the most comfortable for your head? Or did you think it's more an actual design issue that everyone would suffer from? Oh shit, you know what happened then, bro? Bro! What the fuck, dude? No, but I can do it straight away. Now I know you're on eggs. Let me do it now, dude. I said earlier, if anyone catches you in chat, we'll do it. Let me just... Oh, obviously don't log in, dude. Do not log in. How far back we need to go. Do you know when you were actually last on eggs? I'm going to need to open Discord and get your Steam ID as well. Just bear with me one sec, folks. I crouch. Right. Oh my god, you're right down the bottom. 655. Let's have a look. Give me 2 seconds, eggs, and then I give it a whirl, mate. Now, I'm gonna roll back to back end of last week. Now, the only downside is, mate, I did lose my mini bike when I logged in because I think I was actually on it or near it or something. No, I'd actually parked it, hadn't I? That's the thought. Fuck it. But it wasn't there when I got back, so you might have lost the mini bike, same as me, mate. But there's plenty on the server kicking about. right, let's see if that works. Just give me 2 seconds, eggs. I'm just uploading the data. God knows where you'll be, mate, and hopefully you're not in the middle of Anubis. Right, just have a look, dude. See if you can get on there, mate. That was 90, so you're starting... So you're actually starting on 91. Let me bring that up then, Elegon, so I know when I get up there where we are. Brilliant. Nice one, mate. Okay. Let's do the perimeter walk. Yeah, I think this is what happened at Fort Fuck It. Look, I think we just got bars that were actually quite badly damaged, and that horde just happened to be the one that tipped us over the edge, unfortunately. Yeah, to be honest, Eggs, everything was that badly corrupted, dude. I mean, I tried to roll back. I think what happened, to be honest, mate, had already started happening. I think when the server went down, because, for example, I couldn't use my character from the days before backup. So it makes me wonder if the characters were just not saving properly anyway. I don't know. I can't quite get my head around it, mate. All I know is that if they disconnect the server like they did do, we lose our characters. End of story, mate. So they're uncomfortable on your ears, they're tight on your head, and the headband makes the top of your scalp ache after a while. Or it could just be your huge melon. Yeah, well, it's not nice having a headset that's not comfortable. The most important thing, really, isn't it? I mean, can you wear it, you know, as long as you need to wear it? I do know a lot of people do like the earbuds. And I mean, there's some amazingly expensive, and if you look into the tech behind the reason they're expensive, some incredibly advanced, what I call earplugs. But to be honest, I've never worn a good set of earplugs. You know, I've tried many sets over the years, because you always get some, every time you buy a phone or you know, like an iPod or... you know, a myriad of other things, you always get like a little free set of fucking earplugs 9 times out of 10, don't you? I've just never found anything that didn't make it feel like there was pressure actually building up in my ear. I think for me, the most important thing is that the cups don't get sweaty. There's far too many cups that have like a really nasty, cheap plastic. There's some that are plastic, but are better than others, and you can live with those. But I've always found like, a nice fabric on the cup is far more comfortable. I suppose in theory, less hygienic though, because they're far, far more difficult to wash down. But a lot of the good quality headsets actually have replaceable cups anyway, don't they? Or cup padding, should I say. I don't think there's actually as much damage as I thought. It seems to be primarily on that southern side, didn't it? So that's kind of good. You may look like a knob, but you can't watch this. Let's have a look. If this is... I could never buy the Strixes, mate. The other thing is orange as well. I don't like orange. If it was blue, I'd consider it. If it was the last set I could get. No, I just couldn't wear them, mate. They just look weird. £82.25 for full 7.1. They've not got the best of reviews, have they? Wonder if did Mojo, you in chat, did you get that chair, by the way? The reviews are shockingly all over the place, aren't they? Sound quality bad build quality. Here's perfect. Turns out to be a short-term product. Uncomfortable. Low volume. And then you've also got ones where people are really happy with it. Although after even the positive ones said after a year they finally gave up on me. I won't get those, but thanks for the suggestion. I think I'd actually get beaten to death if any of the Rugger lads came around and saw me wearing those, to be honest. So probably best left well alone. You bought two Silent Wings 312. Oh, I know. Yeah, you mentioned those yesterday, mate. Yeah, you mentioned those yesterday. How are you getting on with them? I can hear a Z. Where are you, fella? Hey up, Chuck. Hey up, Chuck. Oh my God! Oh God, it's 10 o'clock! Sticks on sticks, bro! Sticks on. Oh my God! Haha! Tricked ya! Oh, is anyone in the UK watching a show called. Oh, what's it? What is it? The Replacement. Oh my God! It's so good! It's so, so good! The girlfriend has been watching it, and she sort of says, you know, you really want to try and catch up with a couple of things, like let your hair down and watch a bit of TV. And I managed to catch essentially both of the. I think it's a three part sort of show. I think the last one was last week. I think there was another part, maybe Tuesday of this week, and then I think the third episode airs next Tuesday. It's without saying too much, it's basically about a female architect who oh shit, I've got a name, Wood, who falls pregnant. So she's having a baby with her lovely husband, and the company decides to bring in you know, like a temporary replacement to help out on the project that she's working on, building a library. And I won't say much more than that, but oh my God, it's so intriguing. I was like, what? At the end of yesterday's episode, it was like, what the fuck is going on? It's ever so well done. Really, really got, you know, really has got me thinking about, you know, when you think you know what's going on, but you also know that it can't possibly be that because it would just be too obvious. So I can't wait to see, whether or not it's a big plot twist or at least the big revelation next week. Ever so well done. You got a smashing for the lads for looking like a 14-year-old caller. Oh, I'd be beaten to fucking death, mate. Admittedly, I'd beat one of them to death, so. So what the fuck are they on your head, bro? Let's get these down here. Intact around there. Lego World is fantastic. Oh, I didn't think it was out till Friday, mate. Oh, I've got all confused. I thought Kerry and Daz were buying it this Friday. Or is that just when you were buying it then, Kerry? Was it actually out on Tuesday? How good is good, Dominatos? Tell me all about it, because I like my Lego stuff, mate. I do like my Lego stuff. So it is out, yeah. Because don't forget, I mean, obviously America tends to get them on Tuesdays, and we normally have to wait until Friday in the UK, but yeah. So, I mean, I take it, what are you playing it on, Dominatos? What platform? Been watching Crazy Ex-Girlfriend recently. Isn't that a porn channel? Ex-Girlfriend. That's right, isn't it, Elegon? Ex-Girlfriend. Oh, that's a porn channel. Enough of that, Dark. La La La, I can't watch La La Land, mate. I can't watch it. It's never going to happen, mate. It's just never going to happen. I can't in all heart actually go to a cinema and hand over money to watch. Or watch a musical. I just can't. I can't watch musicals, dude. I don't like musicals. I know everyone's been ranting and raving about it, but... You know, there's some things you just got to agree aren't for you. You know, you're not having a pop, you're not having a dig. They're just not for you, mate. Musicals, I'd say a live theatre musical. Now that's a different story. I would enjoy that. You're getting the Xbox One version, are you? It's UK, so it's UK tomorrow, yeah. Yeah. So I'm saying it's a bit annoying sometimes, isn't it, Kerry, when you end up with having to wait a few days to get it when, you know, elsewhere in the world it's already released. It's never made a lot of sense to me, that. Not in this day and age. I understand why it happened back in the day, but... You're playing on the Xbox One and getting a really good... Oh, dude. I'm going to have to watch a bit of YouTube footage. What's the best thing about it, Dominatos? What's the one outstanding thing that sets it aside from all of the games? High School Musical. Is that the one with Zac Efron? If it's got Zac Efron in it, then I'm a massive fan, mate. I like Zac Efron. He's a fucking dude, mate. Where did we get that iron from? Oh, we need to be careful here because we don't want to... very careful we don't take any of this stuff back down. Let's take some cobble wee-wee. Let's take some rebar. Take a few thousand of that. What's up, Bright? What's the clicky-clicky for? You all right? So hang on, what layer is this? So this is layer what? Is this layer... Is this actually 91? I don't even know where we are, Elegon. So this is the front of the build, right? Is that the front of the fucking build? Yeah. Let me just do it. Oh, hang on then, this isn't... Hang on, this must be the front of the build. Oh, hang on, Elegon, what's going on here, dude? It's all backwards, bro. No, sorry, no, that is the back of the build. No, yeah, I've got you. 3, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, all the way around, 5 across, 6 across there, comes into a shaft up, 2, 2, back down, 1, round, inset, 2 across, back, yeah, that's cool. I would say just how lively the world seems. Cool. Yeah, you know what, Kerry? I always used to say when people, you know, ask you, how can you, you know, how did you find Twitch? You know, blah, blah, blah. Well, I came from Justin TV. Justin TV was basically Twitch back in the day. And Justin TV decided to branch off for the gaming side of things because it was getting quite popular into Twitch. And that's how Twitch was born. And I used to watch Justin TV, not because it used to be like social as well as just gaming. It had everything. A little bit like what Twitch is now. So it had like the creative stuff and the musicians and things like that. Obviously when Twitch was born, it was gaming only, wasn't it? And I had like a little group of American streamers on Justin TV that I used to watch quite a lot. On the release of a game because they would be playing it essentially on the Wednesday my time. I could guarantee catching them on the Wednesday playing the latest releases, and I would have Wednesday and Thursday to make my mind up about whether or not to order it, pre-order it, or go and get it, you know? That's sort of where I first came across Justin TV and Twitch, and it was much, much better than the reviews because, one, quite often there was an embargo. And quite often the streams would actually be up before the embargoes lifted. It was very weird back in the day. And on top of that, of course, you had the luxury of actually asking the streamer, you know, like, oh, can you just show me this? Or can you just explain this mechanic? Or, you know, are these settings available? And it was really good, a really good way to get like a first glimpse at a computer game. Lego lions attacking elephants. Holy shit. Make your own custom character build whatever, whenever, wherever. What, so my character can just go and build a helicopter and get in it and fly around? Surely not. Is that for real? You're right, Quinn Lamp, how you doing, mate? It is, Loki, it literally is. I noticed it the second they opened up creative. I thought, well, there you go then. You know, it's gone full circle, hasn't it? Oh, careful. The clatter of the old nail gun, eh? Lost myself in the moment there. Lost it in the rhythm, Elegon. Yeah, we've got 5 days, I think, Anvina, till the next one. Right, I'm just going to have a quick drink, and we'll start on the next layer. So this is 92. You can't build vehicles as such, but you can have... you can have them. It's a bit hard to explain. Can I get a helicopter Dominatus? I mean, the question stands in its simplest of forms. Could my character at some point get a helicopter and fly around in it? What's that, blind? What's up, mate? Are you having problems with your build, Mojo? Oh, that's why it's got the bad review, Socks. It's not the same one you've got then. Well, that might explain it then, dude, because you obviously seem quite happy with yours, don't you? It would explain, it does seem like a ridiculously cheap price, I've got to admit. It's £82 for a full 7.1 headset. You've got to think something's a bit amiss there, ain't you? How long you had it, Socks? Is it like one of those headsets that you'll rebuy when it gives up the ghost one day, or... Well, I said they're quite personal, aren't they, headsets? One person can love and absolutely adore one, and another person just can't wear it just because it physically, you know, is uncomfortable for them, so... You didn't hear Advina's music? I did. Oh, shit, I heard Advina's music. Oh, I wonder if, because I've turned it off, I wonder if OBS doesn't pick it up. Oh, I never thought of that. That's interesting. Does that mean none of the sounds are working then? That means not. I'm going to have to stop and start the stream again and hope my headset doesn't fucking pack in on me. Oh, I'll be back in like 60 seconds. Just get ready to refresh, folks.